As communities of color continue to be disproportionately impacted by COVID-19, I want to talk to you about an important opportunity, and that's enhancing access to monoclonal antibodies.
I'm located in Southeast Louisiana, about 100 miles south of New Orleans. It's a rural location, so we have barriers as far as access, as transportation. We have a critical access hospital that is an 18-bed facility serving about 20,000 folks, and access is a big issue. We had a lot of patients that I think could have benefited from the monoclonal antibodies and missed that opportunity.
People in communities at high risk are not being educated to get monoclonals. That's been the biggest driver for me in COVID, the disparities, the access to care, the access to treatment.
It was very complicated to identify who was eligible. And so what we did at our monoclonal antibody sites is that we modeled what we learned from the nurse telephonic triage line in the very beginning of the pandemic in March. And we had one phone number. And a nurse picks up and immediately starts asking you questions and doing a triage. There are physicians right there who can assist, and they can schedule your appointment that same day. That transportation, all that kind of stuff. So I think that it is so important that the access in has to be the easiest possible, especially when the eligibility criteria is more complex.
The level of distrust that people of color across this country have with the institutions of their society is pervasive, it is deep, and it is damaging. It bleeds into healthcare. We now have a very specific and powerful reason for reaching out to every patient in our patient population. At least they will be well armed with the information about monoclonal antibodies. These are really key elements that all of us have an opportunity to participate in enhancing.
Community health really took on a new meaning. I think you really have to meet people where they are. I think we have to think about the languages that we're reaching out to people. During the pandemic, our marketing department, we have several large communities where Spanish is the primary language spoken, and our marketing department worked very, very hard to have a proactive messaging in people's preferred languages.
We have to really listen to our patients, listen to what their concerns are.
I think we're moving into more of a patient-engaged research model where clinical research becomes a treatment option, and it has to be a treatment option, not just for the select few that have internet and can find out about these trials and advocate for themselves, but for everybody. And what that is going to take is going to take a lot of education, is going to take a lot of thought leaders, and trying to figure out how to level the playing field. Because, you know, clearly that's a challenge for our generation, my daughter's generation, to make healthcare equitable.
We go through a lot of things in medicine, you know, and one of the worst feelings is when you have to walk in there and you don't have anything in your toolbox. Sort of like Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz when she tells the wizard, I don't think there's anything in that bag for me. It's a great feeling when you have something in a bag to give someone. And shame on us if we don't take advantage of this gift. It's a gift.